Hello everyone, welcome back to another new video. Today I will be showing you another chess puzzle where white can win in a seemingly equal pawn endgame with the help of a brilliant move. In the following position, white is up a pawn, but because white's pawn structure is not ideal, it is very difficult for white to create a passed pawn. If white tries to get his king closer to the center with king to f4, black can respond with king to f6, and after king to e4, king to e6, black is able to take control of d5, and as long as black keeps d5 under control, white will never be able to break through, since pawn to c4 is simply met by pawn takes c4 and black's king is in the square of white's passed pawn on the a-file. White must create his passed pawn sooner, but doing so on the first move is also not good because after the pawn is taken, white will need to spend a move to get into the square of black's passed pawn, allowing black to play b5 and white is now the one fighting for a draw. The only move for white to win in the starting position is to play king to f3, and the reason why king to f4 does not work can only be seen in a variation much later in the game. After king to f5, it seems that the game is going to be a draw since black has the opposition, but after the brilliant move pawn to c4, white forces the creation of a passed pawn on the a-file. Since king to e6 will allow white to create a passed pawn on the d-file for free by trading on b5, black captures the pawn on c4, and after pawn to a4, black must play king to e6 to get into the square of white's a-pawn. Again, king to e4 allows pawn to b5, so white must keep advancing his passed pawn on the a-file. Now it seems that black can play king to d7, as after pawn takes b6 king to c8, black will be able to win white's b-pawn, but white can actually win with the move pawn to a6, and after king to c7, white plays the only winning move with pawn to b5, and after c takes b5 pawn to d5, black's king cannot stop both of white's passed pawns at the same time. Therefore, black must first trade on a5 before playing king to d6. Now the point of white's first move is revealed. If white's king is on f4 in this position, king to e3 is met by the move pawn to c5, and after pawn to a6, black can play pawn takes d4 check to trade off white's d pawn with a draw. However, with the king on f3, white can play king to e2, and after pawn to c5 pawn to a6, pawn takes d4 does not come with check, allowing white to play a7 with a winning position. Since king to c7 after a6 again allows d5 and white will be able to promote one of his pawns, black is forced to play king to c7. After white captures the c4 pawn just in time before black captures white's a pawn, white will play king to c5 to capture black's c pawn and promote the d pawn with an easily winning king and queen versus king checkmate. If you want to see more brilliant chess endgames, be sure to like and subscribe for more. I will see you all in my next video. Goodbye.